Lewis Hamilton extended his contract by another 2 years. Alonso will stay with Alpine for at least one more year. Vettel has a 2-year contract currently, and Raikkonen is showing no signs of retirement. With the former stars of Formula 1 still at large when they retire, who is poised to fill that void? Let's find out. Max Verstappen is already a star, so it does not make sense to add him to this list. But regardless of what list we include him, he is definitely going to be relevant in Formula 1 for at least the next 12 to 15 years. With him set to be the next world champion, likely even this year, let's keep him out of this list. With that out of the way, let's see who could become the next Hamilton, Alonso, Vettel, and Raikkonen of Formula 1. Lando Norris. Lando Norris, like Verstappen, is already a star, but unlike Verstappen, he is not even close to having achieved what he is very much capable of achieving. He is yet to get his first pole position, first win, and consistency in reaching the podium. But with McLaren developing the rate at which they are, chances are one day he will become a world champion. And if McLaren falters again, he is definitely a hot candidate to move to Mercedes or even Red Bull one day. Charles Leclerc. Leclerc has achieved a bit more than Norris with a couple of race wins already to his name. But like Norris, he is nowhere near what he is capable of achieving. Looking at how bad Ferrari was in 2020, the way they turned around in 2021 proves that they are moving in the right direction. If it continues, we could see him fighting it up with the likes of Verstappen and Norris on a regular basis for the podium. Unlike most of the F1 YouTubers, I do not rank Leclerc above Norris, but he is definitely capable of keeping Norris on his toes. Carlos Sainz. Sainz is yet to get his maiden Grand Prix victory. Perhaps not as talented as the likes of Verstappen, Norris, and Leclerc, he is probably more hardworking than each of them. This shows in the results as Sainz has managed to finish ahead of Leclerc a couple of times already this season. That, considering the fact that Leclerc has been in Ferrari for 3 years now and had been beating Vettel almost consistently last year, shows how well Sainz has settled into that Ferrari. Maybe he does not enjoy the stardom at Ferrari like Leclerc, but if anyone deserves that seat currently in the grid, it is Sainz. I'm not sure yet if he is still capable of winning a world championship, but it is clear that Sainz could clearly reach the level of Daniel Ricciardo in a couple of years. Pierre Gasly. Pierre Gasly had a solid 2020 and a great 2021 so far. He is able to extract maximum out of that AlphaTauri, but with Perez performing so well in that Red Bull seat, it would be difficult to justify Gasly being promoted again to Red Bull. Gasly is more than likely to remain in AlphaTauri for 2022 season. However, eventually Perez retires, provided that Gasly is still dominating his teammate Tsunoda, we could see Gasly back in that Red Bull and this time performing at a level that does justice to his capabilities. Yuki Tsunoda. It is still very early to say how talented Tsunoda is and how well he performs in Formula 1. So far is evidence he lacks consistency, but he is still too young and he is expected to get better with experience. But he has everything it needs to become a Formula 1 star. It could be at least 3 to 4 years until we see Tsunoda in a car capable of getting to podiums, so he is probably going to have lower impact in the next years. Mick Schumacher. Schumacher had a forgettable season so far, but he is getting what he most needs in the debut season, experience in a Formula 2 car. He probably will take Raikkonen's place at Alfa Romeo once Raikkonen retires, and if he does well there, we could see Schumacher in a Ferrari in 3 to 4 years' time. Like Tsunoda, we have very less evidence to make a prediction how big a star Schumacher will be in the future. We are yet to see if he does Schumacher name justice or would the expectations of the name weigh him down. Honorable mention, Lance Stroll. Lance had a bad reputation initially, having the status of a paid driver occupying a seat that another more talented driver probably deserves more. But he has since proved critics wrong by performing quite well for the car that he is in. He probably will remain in Aston Martin for the foreseeable future, and that means he will probably not be in podium contention very much. But as the current midfield occupies more of the top spots, Lance could occupy the void that is left in the upper midfield. So that's it. Those are the drivers whom I think have the capacity to be the next big names in Formula 1. I purposefully left out Giovinazzi and Ocon from this list. Honestly, I believe they lack the X factor that is needed to be in the elite league. Don't take me wrong, they are good drivers, but they probably won't last as long as the other drivers in the list in Formula 1. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button, consider subscribing to the channel if you like to watch similar content, and stay tuned to I Am Formula for everything Formula 1. Until next time, take care and stay safe.